This video is in direct response to questions posed by Roland, also known as pandoraefretum. Welcome to Harpoon. The question reads, I have recently bought Harpoon Ultimate Edition, and I'm trying to work out the best version to play, if at all, with Naval War Arctic Circle out. Maybe Harpoon has been usurped. Or is Naval War not as deep as Harpoon? What about Global Conflict Blue 2? Well, we can try to. This is a good question, and I'll start with the Naval War Arctic Circle, or I'll just call it Arctic Circle for short. Arctic Circle has come out, and I've had an opportunity to try the demo and run through the tutorials. Now, this is a personal opinion, but I find Arctic Circle, it's got some nice features to it, but I find it a little bit limited, almost a little bit as though it's unfinished. Now, there are fans for Arctic Circle for certain, and they've worked well, and they've gotten things to work good for them. And they've been brave enough to put out a demo so people like us can try it for ourselves. However, I find there's a bunch of things that seem to be just missing that would make the game complete. For example, some of the major things for me are the inability to really check enemy units on the database. For example, I can't find out what the enemy might be carrying, might be the range of his weapons, other detail. I can find it out for mine, but maybe I just missed something there. As well, the lack of a scenario editor is a major hindrance. Now, the developers have said that players will be able to create scenarios because they'll send out all the information on XML format files. That's great, and it's nice to see that there will be some scenario possibilities. However, I think this is the same error that Harpoon Ultimate has kind of made. And let me pull up the Harpoon 3 scenario editor. This is the Harpoon 3 scenario editor. To create a new scenario, we have all these different tables, menu selections that we can select from. We can generally figure this stuff out, a little trial and error, and we can start making scenarios and creating missions and whatnot. Tables like this are quite easy. We can click the various radio buttons, and once we find out our manual on how to do these, it's not too bad. Now, recently, Harpoon Ultimate has gone a step further to try and give us more control over our scenarios. Harpoon Ultimate has tried to give us more control over the various missions by putting them into these doctrine files. Now, if you take a look at one of these, can you figure out how they work? I can't, and I've been playing this for years. Now, I probably could figure it out and go through trial and error and fix up each and every one, but they've offered nothing. There's no explanation on how these work and what parameters these cover and how they're supposed to be changed, except for some very, very basic explanations. So, while we can figure out the previous screen, as you can see, we can click radio buttons and fill in different blanks, and we can get scenarios to work. If we had to make scenarios in this manner and organize it along this way, how many of you would be interested in doing it that way and would be willing to spend the time to learn how to do it that way? Now, it's not impossible, but it's not very user-friendly. And this is why I think the use of XML files, it should work. However, the learning curve could be quite high, and this was very, very well explained. And having gone through the manual and the tutorials with Naval War Arctic Circle, the explanations are quite lacking. Global Conflict 2 appears to fall into the same trap. There is in a dedicated scenario editor, and you can create scenarios with a number of files, but it's quite awkward. And until they actually get a nice scenario editor that's easy to use, I think that's going to be a severe limitation for their customers. As well, Arctic Circle is limited to a very small area. When playing Harpoon, any of the versions, you can pretty much play it anywhere in the entire world, from the polar ice caps to the equator, without limitation. This is a good thing. Now, this shouldn't be so critical of Arctic Circle. They have made a game, and they've been brave enough to put up a demo so people can try it. So, kudos to them, and wishing them the best. I'm just not certain that it has the depth that I like. So I don't have the details that get into it. I don't like the way it has been presented. The focus on things like 3D simulations, helicopters flying and whatnot, I find personally very silly and a waste of time. The first thing I tried to do was turn it off, and I couldn't even do that. When they spend that much time on creating 3D images, they're taking away from something else, and I personally don't find that very useful. So there, while Arctic Circle will have its fans and its followers, and I wish them well, I just don't think it's a game for me. It's a little simple for my taste. Now, Global Conflict Blue 2 is not finished, hasn't been offered yet, and they've made some very good advances as they release different versions, but they're few and far in between, and it's almost like it's in a continuous alpha state. The reason why I say it's continuous alpha is they seem to be, they fully admit, a meandering progression, where they sometimes they'll change things totally drastically and go in a different direction. Well, they're still in development. It's a free phase, so no one's being charged for it. But the fact that they're going all over the place, in my opinion, means that I'm just not interested in that game at this time. Once they come out with a completed version, I might be interested, and it does look like they have some very promising features and function, but the same limitation is they're all over the place, so I'm putting in a lot of time learning something that may not stick. The lack of a scenario dedicated scenario editor is another problem. And so I'm waiting for the final product to come out. Global Conflict 2 just isn't ready yet. Now, the next part of the question reads, at first sight, the number of Harpoon versions is confusing. What should someone start out with as of April 2012? HUE, I have read, has 240 anomalies, ANW slightly less, and 363 is the most reliable, correct? Does this mean that 3.63 is bug-free, or does it have 60 or so anomalies? Another good question. Now, we'll answer the first part of the different versions. There are actually four different versions of Harpoon. We have Harpoon Ultimate Commander's Edition, and then we have the Harpoon 3 different versions of Harpoon 3. If you are unfamiliar with the difference between Harpoon Classic and Harpoon 3, you can take a look at the video, and we've included a link. Here. To see the difference between the Harpoon Classic and Harpoon 3. Now, for your question in regards to the Harpoon 3 different versions of Harpoon 3, Harpoon Ultimate yet Advanced Naval Warfare version 3.10, also known as HUE, is the buggiest, has 240 reported anomalies, and some of them are huge, some of them not so huge, but they're all there. Of course, she has also some additional functions and features, but it is the buggiest. The previous version release is ANW, or 3.94 we call it, and it has many bugs that Harpoon 3.6 does not have. Harpoon 3.6 also has problems, but there has some big ones. There's maybe five or so really big ones, and the rest are annoying, but you can generally get around. See, the difference with players' databases, we're honest with the problems. If you look on the Harpoon forum, Harplonk forum, you can see we also have a list of known Harpoon 3 issues. And if you will check out the link, and you can see we've identified also all the same problems as before. Now, because Harpoon 3.6 is no longer being supported by the developers, there won't be any code changes. So we know all these are, you either live with these or play a different game. But they're all here, and you can find them listed as well. As I said, as before, there are a few really, really big ones in Harpoon 3, but for the most part, they can be worked around. Now, Harpoon, the next part of the question is, Harpoon 3.6 does not have a screen resolution that suits my widescreen laptop, nor can I get an installer to install it because it doesn't seem to register two different files. So, for a novice like myself, is it going to be a big difference if I just use Harpoon Ultimate with the complete player's database? Are the anomalies in HUE resolved or at least tolerable? In other words, which is the best version considering I'm using the player's database? Well, by using the player's database, you're getting the most reliable, most functional. Player's database has problems just because there are game bugs, but in general, the most important thing is your weapons fire, your planes launch, your ships move. Not every database can say that. None of the other databases can say that. Here we've reported problems with Harpoon Users Database, Y2K Database, ANW Database, all the things that are issued by the developer, and we've reported problems, and they just don't care. They don't care, they don't fix them, so we know that player's database is the most functional. It's not perfect. We don't know. We can always find something, but the difference is, if you find a problem with the player's database, you'll get it fixed within 3 hours or 3 days, not 3 weeks, 3 months, or 3 years. You get it fixed now, if we can. So, by using the player's database in any of the versions, you are at the best chance of actually having a complete scenario finish. Now, speaking of the difference between HUE and H3, if you're using HUE, personally, I avoid HUE and ANW whenever possible. It's just not worth my time. You'll be getting crashes, all really weird behaviors, weapons firing, planes taking off on their own, doing whatever they like. Your surface-to-air missiles, your air-to-air missiles, will just you have very little control over them. If you don't know, one of the examples is the weapons tight command, and here is the link for it. You can watch it for yourself to see this is a really major problem with ANW. They kind of fixed it with HUE, as you can see in the video, but then they broke it again badly in HUE. They claim that they're fixing it for the next patch, but I'll believe it when I actually see it, because the patch is not an open. I can't seem to get it. It doesn't seem to run right now. Now, the anomalies with the player's database, when you're using the player's database in HUE, you'll get the best result because we've actually tried to work around some of those anomalies. The ones we can get around, we work around. The ones we can't, they're affecting everybody already. So that those are we would call them game bugs. The ones we could, for example, if the AI is unable to use a certain weapon in a certain way, we would have tried to fix it by making a workaround if it was available. That's why our weapons actually fire. Whereas you see that some of the other databases, they'll come out with a weapon, they'll set up, and they may or may not be realistic value parameters. But then you go to a game and you try to fire them, and they never fire. Under any circumstance, they never fire. So what's the point of having a parameter which makes the game unusable They claim to be realistic, but if realistic means non-functional, well, I prefer to be functional than their definition of realistic. So that's why I only use the Harpoon 3.6 version of the game. Is the rest is just not worth my time. At least with Harpoon, if you want to try the different versions, we have made scenarios that are playable in Harpoon Classic. You can try that same scenario in Harpoon 3, then try it again in ANW, and try it one more time in HUE. This we suggest, by all means, we make this available to you so that you can pick the version you like. If you like Harpoon Classic, good for you. If you like Harpoon 3, good for you. If you prefer ANW or HUE, good for you. We make them available so you can decide for yourself which is best for you. Now, you say that Harpoon 3.6 does have a screen resolution that doesn't suit my widescreen laptop. This is true. Harpoon 3.6 was built nearly 18 years ago, and they didn't have widescreen format. It doesn't support widescreen format. So for this reason, it looks really weird. And personally, I would recommend for you to play it in the reduced window format. Now, to use in the reduced window format, we will go into the Harpoon 3.6 version of the game. Now, there are two different Harpoon 3 launchers available out there. One comes with the game and one does not. Now, I'll show you how to do it the manual way without the launcher. So this is the Harpoon 3.6. There is no configuration launcher that comes with the game. I'll show a link where you can get one, but I don't use the one that comes with the game simply because it's not very, I don't find it very useful. So we'll go into our Harpoon 3.6 version folder, and this is the default path for that folder. Look under the options subfolder, and you can see this run in window option file. Make sure it appears here. Sometimes it shows in the disabled. Now, by having it in the disabled, that means you would not be running in reduced window. Once you make sure of this, these are the options we recommend for Harpoon 3 when running. And by putting them outside the disable folder, that means these are the options that are enabled. Inside the disabled, these are the ones that are currently disabled. Now you don't need the launcher to move them back and forth. You just take them out and drag them or drop them in somewhere else. So by having the run in window, we're going to be running on a reduced window. And we can go back to the launcher and we can start up. Now, this launcher, by using the one that comes with the game, you're pretty much stuck with the various animations, and you can click on them and they'll disappear. See how the reduced window format is? And it's small. Now, by using reduced window format, the proportions of your range circles will be correct. For example, we'll just start the first scenario, and we will activate our preferences, and we'll just say something simple, anti-air. Notice how the circle is nice and round. Now, when playing if you want to use the full window format, we're going to quit this one, and we'll just leave it. To use the full window format, we'll move it over to the disabled function, and we'll run again. Sorry about that, folks. I forgot that when running in full window format on my computer, the screen shows up as a total, pretty much black, and the video is unable to record this. So I apologize for forgetting about this, and I think you can follow along with my description, but you won't see it very well. You can see this elongated text and windows. This is because the old Harpoon 3 does not support these wide screens. And we'll do the anti-air again. Now you can see that this is not bad, because this scenario is near the equator. However, as you zoom in, you notice that this circle isn't a circle. It's more like an ellipse. So it's kind of stretched out. It's not perfect, but you can play on a full window format should you choose to do so. For sake of clarity, and I prefer using the reduced window format simply because viewers, I don't want to have distorted what might appear to be distorted shapes. And we can move the where does it run in window now? There we are. We move it back out into the enabled folder. Should you wish to use a different launcher, it's a little bit more complicated, and I'll show you where you can find it. SubSim is a very professional site that hosts, that has supported Harpoon for a long, long time. Here is the downloads library for SubSim. You need to have a membership, but memberships are free, and SubSim does not ban very capriciously the way Matrix and HarpGamer and other sites do. So you can find a mod for Harpoon 3, and the launcher for this Harpoon 3 older version is here. And you can check out, this is from an old player. However, to use this launcher in Harpoon 3, the version released by Matrix in 2010, is a bit complicated, simply because you should be able to follow these instructions, and you should be fine if you wish to use this launcher. There's no obligation, no need. I just personally use this launcher because I find it more helpful than the one provided by Matrix. Now, the last part of the question is, lastly, manually editing the INI file for H3, do I point the battle set folder to battle set or battle set, spelled incorrectly, with the player's database installed? Where can I get information about what goes on with the INI with regards to player's database? Now, this is another good question. The difference is with the H3 installer, we've had this problem. See, in the original release of H3 in 1994, the game was restricted to 8 characters, and they couldn't fit battle set in because that would be 9 characters. So they misspelled it and just simply took out one of the E's, simply because the folder management system didn't allow for this. Now, when Matrix released the game re-released the game in 2010, they went ahead and they changed the spelling to battle set proper. Now, that isn't a big thing, but it wasn't broken in the first place. It's just another change for the sake of making it, well, it's correction, of course, but it wasn't broken, and they fixed something that wasn't broken, and as a result, broke a number of other things. Hence, in order to use the Harpoon 3 launcher from Paolo Moneta, you need to make those changes, as we showed before. Not impossible, but it's just for the I personally thought it was an unnecessary change, just convoluted. Now we have people with the incorrectly spelled one and with this one. The problem now, we didn't want to confuse anybody. We were having problems. People were installing it, and so they were installing to the wrong place. So, in order to make it your lives as easy as possible, Players Database has always been about making the user's life as easy as possible. Instead of having you change things around and spell it one way or the other way, or mucking around with your INI and changing this or changing that and possibly breaking something, all we did was, when you run the Harpoon 3 players database installer, we're going to create a folder for this one for Battleset properly spelled and Battleset improperly spelled. So we take out the problems for you. You're going to get a duplicate copy. You're going to get two of them. So you don't have to worry about it. If you point when you run the installer, which can be found on any of our helpful messages at this link for Harpoon 3.6, this installer will create both folders for you, both the Battleset and the Battleset, the misspelled one. So we've tried to solve the problem for you. The only thing that you need to do when with this Harpoon 3.6, you need to be able to point to the correct folder so that you can install this, which is the default path for your folder. If you change the default directory, then you'll have to point it to the right one. But this is the one issued from Matrix Games. If you are uncertain how to run a Players Database installer, you can check out this video. And here is the path. This will show you how to install either Harpoon 3, the Players Database for Harpoon 3, for ANW, and for HUE versions. In conclusion, if there are any other questions, feel free to post them. We're here to help. Good luck, and welcome aboard, shipmate.